Hi you guys, it's Asia Marka here, Lemon Creation, and I have a project today for Lindy Skunk, and it's a very different project, especially for those of you who are on the budget. I want to show you how with three of Lindy's colors you can create the whole color wheel. So the idea behind it is very simple. When I started, I could not afford to buy tons of Lindy's products, even though they are really fabulous and not that expensive. But it's like that. Not everybody can afford. I wanted to show you how easily you can get all the colors you wish. So what I've done, I created a circle, I divided it into 12 equal parts, and at the end of each part or each slice of the pie, I added a circle. Each circle will represent either primary, secondary or tertiary color. And I am with a ruler making the lines in between them, because you'll see at the end the lines will help us to create even more colors. Do not be afraid to do that, and if you can, do the exercise with me, even though I had to speed up the video because simply it would take over 1 hour otherwise. But try to do it with me, it's not very complicated and you will be very, very happy with the results. And so now I am starting with mixed color palette. Mixed means that I used three different Lindy's products. So I use Magical Shaker, Spray and Magical. For this particular color wheel, I used Cuckoo Clock Cardinal. That's the red one I'm actually making right now. So I just dilute the powder with water. The first color I put was a Summer Loving Sun. And the third one, it's a Magical and it's a Hydrangea Blue. And of course you can put it on the proper color palette, but I found it's less intimidating if your palette is quite big, and since I don't have a big one, I use a piece of packaging which works perfectly. So you dilute the colors and you keep them separate, that's very important. And try of course to dilute them as much or as well as possible. Always use clean water. I have two jars, but as you can see, my water is already black, so I will change it. And be careful that the colors, for now, don't mix. Take also a piece of scrap paper. That will be very useful later, and you'll see why. And I change my water, and I start with the primary colors. So on the top, I'll put red. And you can wet the paper before. I work on the mixed media paper. It's not even watercolor paper, it's mixed media paper. But you don't have to wet the circles before, you can just add the color as it is. So you add these three primary colors. They are four circles apart from each other. The next thing is to create secondary color. So you take a tiny piece, you take a little bit of primary color. In this case, I'm creating green, so I take a little bit of yellow and a little bit of blue, and I create my green color. Because the colors are having different values, that's why the scrap paper is very useful, because sometimes, you know, you add a little bit more of blue and it will create not really a green color. So always check that on the piece of your paper. When you are happy, go ahead and do it, put it on the color wheel. And this is the second one I was doing here. It was yellow and red, which helped me to create orange. But as you can see, this orange was too strong, was more reddish, So I added a little bit of yellow. And then I put it in the middle, in between these primary colors. So again, I'm creating secondary ones now. I take a little bit of red and a little bit of blue. I try to put them equal in equal amount, but sometimes that doesn't work. As I said to you, the colors have different values, so some of them are stronger, you have to add a little bit more. In this case, I have to add a little bit more of red because the blue is quite strong, to create my purple. And that's again why I'm checking it on my scrap paper when I'm happy with it. When I know that the secondary purple is done correctly, I'll put it on the wheel. And now the other fun part, you're gonna create tertiary colors. So basically, to create tertiary colors, you take two colors which are beside each other and you create the one which is lacking in the middle. I hope that makes sense. So in that case, I took secondary purple and primary red. And I'm gonna get this mauve color. Again, I need to check on the piece of paper if it's not too similar to the purple. And if it's not, if I'm happy, I'll put it in the place of tertiary color in between purple and red. I hope, guys, you are following. I'll do two more color palettes like that, so I hope by the end of this video you will actually know the idea and you will be quite comfortable with doing it. So now a little bit of orange and a little bit of red, so secondary orange and primary red, and we are going for this kind of color in between red and orange. Depending on the colors you use, sometimes you could get beautiful coral. Me, I got I have no idea how is it called, but you can see that the colors are not the same. It's not red, it's not orange. And next part is to mix yellow, primary, and the secondary orange. And again, you're gonna get kind of orangey color, but more into a yellow. It's not yellow, it's not orange, it's in between. That's the value in between those two colors. And the next one, a little bit of green, secondary, and a little bit of yellow. That will give us a beautiful spring green color. And you can see already here, I didn't even have to check on the scrap paper because I've seen it that it is different than it used to be. And again, a little bit of primary blue and a little bit of secondary green. You mix them up and you get a beautiful turquoise or teal. And the last color we are left with, we will get by mixing the secondary purple and the primary blue. So once again, try to put the same amounts of each paint and just fill up this circle. Next extra step is something you don't have to do, but if you want to get more colors, and you can just go ahead and do it. So now I am gonna be mixing colors which are on the opposite end of each other. So in this case, primary red and secondary green. If I add more green and mix them together, the value I'll get, I have to put on the side of the green color. Now I'll add a tiny bit more of red, and the value I'll get, I'll add at the end of the red color. Now, tertiary coral and tertiary teal, I'll mix them together, adding, if I add more teal color, I'll put it on the side of the teal. If I add more coral, I'll put it on the side of coral. So in this case, when you do these color lines, you actually don't mix colors in the equal amounts. Mauve and tertiary spring green. When I add more spring green, I'll put it on the side of the spring green. If I add more mauve, I'll put it on the side of the mauve color. Once again, now we are doing a purple and primary yellow. So I'm adding a lot of yellow, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it's a lot of yellow with a tiny bit of purple. So I will put it on the side of the yellow circle because there is a majority of yellow color. And now I'll add a tiny bit more of purple and I'll add it on the purple circle. And so on and so forth. This is of course the part you don't have to do, but I just find it a very good exercise and it's quite enjoyable and you can get the colors you did not think you can get. Also, there is one more tip for you. Normally when you mix three primary colors, you will get black. That does not always work. Depends really on the colors and probably of the saturation. For this project, I actually simply forgot to see if I'll get the black, but I guess I probably will, at least with one of the colors color wheels I'm doing. I'd be very happy if you do it along with me. You can always pause the video if it's too fast for you. It could be intimidating at the beginning, but believe me, I learned to do it not that long ago and I really like. And if you practice, you'll get instantly, you will know which colors create which colors, and this is really great. Apart from the stain there on the side of the red one, the color wheel looks beautiful. And in this color wheel in particular, you get a little bit of shine, or mostly shine, but you also get with the primary flat Fabio, you get a flat color. So this is also very cool because you get your shiny and flat colors. Next exercise or color wheel. For this one, I'm gonna be using a Squirts. So I already prepared my color wheel. Again, I put the of names, I think, tertiary, secondary, primary. So like that, you'll see where I'm putting my paints. And after shaking very well Squirts, you need to shake them well to get all the shine. And they are all shiny, so you're gonna get a shiny color wheel. I'm starting to work on my color palette. I'm starting again with a primary yellow, with primary red, and with primary blue. Of course, the full colors of the list of colors I used, you're gonna get in the description box below or on the Lindy's blog, so just check that out over there. And now I'm making my secondary colors. A little bit of yellow, a little bit of red, more or less the same amount, checking if that's enough. Obviously, the red is stronger than yellow, so I have to add a little bit of yellow to get my orange one. The next one is a little bit of yellow and a little bit of blue, which will give us a beautiful green. And again, I have to add yellow because the green was too green. And here we go, a beautiful forest green. And a little bit of red and a little bit of blue, which gives us a purple. Of course, you can play with colors and you can add the secondary and tertiary colors the way you want, with the saturation you want. But basically, well, secondary colors are purple, green and orange, so you kind of have to keep to them, and then you work with the tertiary. So next one is the tertiary in between the red and orange. So it should give us a little bit of corally look. And I'm double checking it on my scrap paper. And when I'm happy with the results, I can put it back on the color wheel. And now secondary orange and primary yellow once again. So you're gonna see in the place in between, you're gonna put the mix of those two colors. Primary yellow and secondary green. As you can see, the primary yellow in case of Squirts is not really yellow. It's a little bit darkish, but that's what I said. With different colors, you'll get different results. This is really great. You know, you will have so many combinations and not even one palette will be the same because all depends on the colors you use, on the saturation. And again, green and blue will give you the kind of a teal one. And then blue and purple will give you a little bit like a dark blue denim maybe. And we have one place left for the purple and red, which will give us this mauve color. I hope I pronounced that okay, if not, well, I'm sorry, but you'll see the color, so you'll know what I'm talking about. And then the last thing to do with this palette is to add or mix the colors which are on opposites to each other. So again, I'm using a tertiary and two tertiaries actually. All depends on the amount of colors used. So if you add more of green, you put it on the side of green. If you add more of purple, you put it on the side of purple and you continue like that. I let you just have a look at that because I'm thinking that maybe me talking all the time, it's a little bit disturbing. So just have a look at how I'm working. I'm trying now to show you with fingers which colors I am mixing together. So just have a look. So this color wheel, even if it's really beautiful, I found it's a little bit darker than the first one, than the previous one I've created. Maybe because of the yellow, which is quite dark. It's actually not even yellow, it's a Poutine gold, so it's goldish. But still, it's so beautiful. All the primary colors are there, secondary also and tertiary. And there is a shimmer, because they are squirts, they are with shimmer. So we have a beautiful, beautiful shimmer and different color values than in the first one. And I'm gonna create now a color wheel with flat magicals. And for that, I will just let you quiet and let you hopefully create with me without me talking, just quietly. Just hopefully you'll enjoy the process. The color palette is quite similar to the first one. The colors are beautiful, they are very bright, although there is no shimmer at all because I use only flat magicals, which is great also. Not all of us like the shimmer, and like that you can create your own flat color wheel. So that's it, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I hope I'll show you or I show you the ways to use your colors. I hope I gave you ideas on how you can create your own colors. And for those of you who are on the budget, I hope this is something useful as well. If you create your own color wheels, please share them on the Lindy's Gang, Lindy's Creative Gang on Facebook. And I hope I'll see you soon. Bye bye.